Hello, and welcome to another episode of Patents TV. I'm your host, Jeff Bond. This is episode 52, and this is also our featured vendor presentation. And as you can see, I've got my stocking cap, my Santa Claus cap on, because we're just really days away from Christmas. And we've got our winter solstice background going, so I just hope I don't end up like Buffalo, New York, and end up piled with snow around the set in 15 minutes. Again, this is our special presentation of a vendor, a featured vendor. And our featured vendor today is Empower Learning. And they are going to show two pieces of equipment. And they're both from Promethean. The first is the active table. And the second is the active panel. And so Jeff and Jonathan are going to give us a little rundown on just how those devices work and how they will benefit students in the school districts.
Hi, I'm Jeff Tucker, and this is Jonathan Trietsch. We're with Empower Learning. We are a local education technology company that brings you interactive technology products and solutions for students with special needs.
In fact, Jeff, we are a woman-owned business. We offer a single point of contact all the way from sales, installation, training, and services.
Yeah, we've been a Promethean Premier Partner since 2007, and we also bring you solutions and consult on bring-your-own-device one-to-one solutions, as well as GAF solutions.
And now we're going to take a quick moment to show you guys a demonstration of the Promethean Active Table.
So this is the Promethean Active Table, and this is a very collaborative and consensus-based device. It's going to be something that's going to foster a lot of interaction amongst the students. And we can have up to six students working around this table at the same time. It's a multi-touch screen, so it allows those students to be able to interact while working on the table at the same time. There is an IR bezel around the screen that allows for that touch recognition to happen. And it is running a Windows 7 computer, so there's no need to hook up any external devices. It is an all-in-one unit. So let's go into some of the activities. There are over 180 activities available for download right now, and all of those activities are free. Promethean does not charge for any of the activities that they develop. They are open source and free for you to download. So we're going to go into one of the activities and applications right now. We just tap on our main screen here. As you can see, it's a very circular-based menu, so there's really no head of the table, so to speak. So we're going to go into Making CVC Words, and this activity is going to allow us to work together to create different cards that you'll see here in just a second. Again, back to the consensus-based. I have it set up right now for two learners. I've got one right here and one right here. But as I said, you can have up to six working around the table at one time. I'm going to say OK to go into the activity. So as it loads up the activity, you're going to see basically a lazy river around the activity with all of our different pictures. And the object of this activity is to take one of our cards out of the pile, and we have, like I said, several different students working on the cards at the same time. We're going to drag a picture out of the lazy river, and each picture is going to have a little yellow icon. It's a speaker icon, and it's going to tap that.
Dog.
It's going to tell you what that picture is if you're not sure. So we just need to drag that picture of that dog onto our card. Now we need to work on finding the consonant, vowel consonant combinations to complete this card. So I'm going to come over to my list of letters over here, my consonants, and I believe this is a D. We're going to check the little speaker icon just to make sure.
D. D.
It says the D sound, and as you can tell, there are speakers built in. Additionally, there are four headphone jacks, so if you have small groups working around the room, you could have the students working quietly with those headphones on. So we're going to associate that consonant D to our card. Now we need our vowel consonant. We've got it right here.
Og.
You can see it's giving us the sound there, so we can associate that to the card. Once we've completed our card, we can move that into our basket, and we're ready to complete another card. So we could have students working on various aspects of this. Maybe one student is responsible for finding all the consonants, and if they want to drag that card into the river here, it can be passed on to the next student who can take that card out and complete the project. Once we are finished with this, We can go into our little icon here and go through our toolbox. So if we wanted to restart this activity, we could do that from the toolbar. We can do sound recordings on this. There are inputs for that. Each activity is going to have the ability to exit, which is what is shown right here. If we wanted to exit, every student needs to say okay to move out of that activity. If we're not done and one student catches that, they can just hit that little red frowny face and it's going to take us back into the activity. So if we wanted to even send this information to the teacher, we could hit that for teacher button, and here we will say okay. What this is going to do is create a PDF that will show the teacher what's going on within the activity at the conclusion of the students being on the activity. Right now it's asking us to copy this to a USB. You could potentially copy that to a thumb drive and put that onto our computer. There are four USB ports on the table which can transfer information. For right now, we're going to say no, but we do want to view the document. So here we'll say yes. It's going to create that PDF document that's going to show us exactly what was going on at the conclusion of the activity. From here, we can gain a little bit more information as to what was going on. We can see the cards that were created. We've got our dog card here. We can go into the next bit of information here, find out exactly what was going on with each student, the amount of time that they were manipulating the different cards, how many cards they had contained, different sounds played, that sort of data you can gain from this. We can see what the individual students were doing with working with the different tools. And then we've got our heat map, and this is going to show us exactly where the interaction was taking place. So here we have it set up for the two students. As you can see on this side of the table, which was my token over here, this is the main interaction points. We didn't really have too much going on this side of the table, simply because there were no students or interactions taking place there. So as a teacher, you could potentially be working with other small groups around the room, come back to this activity once it's completed, and talk with the students and talk through everything that was going on, find out if there were questions, basically have that dialogue with the students of what this activity was accomplishing. So we can close out of our for teacher PDF there and either go on to continuing working on the activity, or in our case, we're going to close out, hit exit. Again, we all have to agree to move out of the activity, and we're going to go on to play another activity. That was our CVC words. Now we can use an activity called Let's Go Shopping. This one is going to be a good activity to help students understand the value of money and see really how a small economy or commerce would work. So we're going to say okay on both of these tokens to move into our Let's Go Shopping activity. And from here, we will have six different small businesses, so to speak, set up. And this is going to have the students working at each of these individual businesses and buying and selling goods to each other. So here in our toy emporium, you can see here, we've got a cash register and a list of items that we need to buy. Now we can talk to the other students and have them purchase or sell us the different items, like say an apple. If we've got the apple here, we want to find our other student that's got the apple for sale, which is going to be in this student's grocery. So we've got the apple right here, and we can go ahead and tap on that apple to see that apple is 23 cents. So now I need to get 23 cents out of my cash register. I'm just going to take two dimes out of there. It's going to actually take those out of my cash register, as well as the three pennies. And we can move those over to our other student's cash register, and we've made that purchase. So this is a good activity to show students the value of money and basically how to buy and sell goods. Again, in the activity, we have different tools that we can use. One thing I do want to mention too, in the beginning of every activity, there is a help button, which is going to allow us to see the directions for each individual activity. So whether it was our CVC words activity or our Let's Go Shopping, this instruction sheet is going to tell us exactly how to interact with the activity. So we're going to go ahead and close that out. and say we've completed this activity. We can again go ahead and restart that, send the information in a PDF form to the teacher, or go ahead and exit. So I'm going to exit out here, get back out to our main menu. Now I will point out some of the different abilities to interact with this table. As you can see, I'm sitting down in a chair. This is tall enough for a student, maybe that's in a wheelchair, to be able to come right up to the table and interact. Maybe for students that have motor skills issues, we can use different types of pointers and wands to interact with this table. Again, this is an IR bezel around the table, so it's going to recognize touch points and not necessarily the heat of a finger to be able to interact. So again, if you have students that use pointers of that sort of thing to interact, we can do that with this table. So with that, we're going to turn it over to Jonathan and tell us a little bit more about the active panel.
All right, thanks, Jeff. With me here is the Promethean active panel. This is going to use similar technology to what was in the active panel that Jeff showed, where we have an infrared bezel all the way around, which will allow the students to have multiple points of contact. So in this particular activity, the students can drag different letters out of the word bank to create different words. This is just one of the many resources that is available on Promethean's website called Promethean Planet. It is a community of about 2 million teachers with over 100,000 resources that are available to the teachers for free. One of the other things I'd like to show you is an application called Fresh Paint. This allows the students to be creative. We can use any other stylus or pointer, or in this case I have an ordinary paintbrush, and we can grab different colors from our palette and jump in here and paint different things. So in this instance we've painted a tiger. I do want to jump into one other application called Bing Maps, where the students can take virtual tours around the world.
Well, thanks, Jonathan. Thank you for just showing us just a few of the activities and applications that can foster that collaboration and interaction with your students on a daily basis at the Active Panel. We appreciate you spending some time with us today. If you have any questions or would like to schedule an on-site demo of the Promethean Active Table or Active Panel, please just contact us and we'd be more than happy to work with you on these projects.
Well, I want to thank Jeff and Jonathan for their presentation on showing the Promethean Active Table and Active Panel. Two really, really good devices for use with students in the classroom. Very versatile and just a good deal. Speaking of that, I would like to touch base on their website, and it is at epower-learning.com. So you need to make sure you get that hyphen in there, or it's going to end up taking you somewhere else. And they've got a lot of different products besides Promethean. So again, you can take a look at their website. We'll have that information on our patents website. That's patentsproject.com. Information will be there. Jeff did mention that there's a quick promotion. If you'd like to get the Promethean 70-inch board for the 65-inch price, they're going to do that for until December 23rd. So they'll take POs. If you want to get that in, if you happen to have an opportunity to do that, please do it. So again, thanks for Jeff and Jonathan's information on Promethean Active Table and Active Panel. And with that being said, we're going to go ahead and sign off. I didn't get any snow on my desk, so I'm pretty comfortable with that. Heck, got a little bit warm and it was messing up my hair. So with that, we're going to say goodbye and happy holidays. And we'll see you next year. This is the end of 2014, when Jim Lambert, our patent site coordinator from Crown Point, is going to be back. And we're going to be talking about e-reader apps, primarily for the iPad or iDevices, even though they still cover the Androids. But what we want to do is show you just kind of how you could make a selection, given some of the study guides and basic skills and stuff that they have available, and then you can go out and check those apps out for yourself. So again, we'll be doing that January 6th, I believe it is. Another plug real quick, Tuesday, April 23rd is going to be our Tech Expo. It's going to be here in Indianapolis. It's free to anyone that wants to come. We'll have plenty of parking. We'll provide lunch, but it is completely vendor driven. And so people like Empower Learning will be there with the Promethean Active Table and maybe the Active Panel, and we'll see what they bring there. But again, vendor driven and lots of things to do. So that's, again, Tuesday, April 23rd. With that, I will say goodbye.